dream of trying to baby. Gazing them days and contagious, show my baby. It's your girl Asia.
And it's your boy BJ.
Back in the building.
Back in the fact.
Back like we never left.
As you can see by that thumbnail, what we're getting into right now, we're getting into the BGs, For Whom the Bell Tolls. Yeah. This is actually a live performance in New York in 1993. We definitely got to send a big shout out to one of our loyal supporters for making this as a suggestion.
Yeah.
If y'all are new to the channel, we appreciate y'all for tapping in. Go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so y'all can see more videos from Asia and BJ.
Yeah.
But y'all, let's go ahead and get into the video. Let's go, y'all. Come on.
Let's go on and get into this video, y'all. It is so freaking hard to sing outside and hear each other. No, like for real. Like
it
it's really hard to just, it's just hard. Okay. Yeah. Like, because the sound is different. It sounds different. Like,
Yeah, it is hard to sing outside.
I like the look, and they even got the Statue of Liberty in the background and stuff. Like, what a nice little view and everything. But I wasn't expecting for him to sound like that.
Yes, I mean, come on, like this right here, it already gives me that whole classic vibe, just that whole laid back feel that the kind of like the Bee Gees give y'all. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And for, I guess from what we've seen, being that that was like a kind of a different time for them, and then looking at them at, like now, like, it's almost a lot, obviously it's a lot different.
It is.
It's almost like you're looking at two different eras in time.
Mm-hmm.
But I like it so far. I mean, it's just.
I do too.
I guess I was going to say I wasn't expecting, I said all that to say. I wasn't expecting for him to sound like that, but now I can see how much more similar, like some kind of, I don't know why, maybe I'm hearing it differently, but I can see.
I like, their laid back vibe.
Yeah, they're very similar in sound, but like they were saying to us before, they were like, no, girl, they got harmonization in
exactly.
there, but they brothers and they sound the same.
Exactly. And they do.
They do. Yeah, they do.
See me losing you.
And not to say how freaking cold it probably is out there too, y'all.
That too.
It looked cold outside.
Yeah, but they make it sound good though.
They sound really good. Yeah, they sound good. And this is a lot better than what I like heard from them initially. In terms for me, I just feel personally this sounds so much better than, like, I could see why they was really like, you know, messing with the Bee Gees back then.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
They sound good though.
They do.
That was so beat me, busted my ass.
Yeah, this definitely got to be like Christmas time too, obviously.
Yeah.
The Christmas tree and everything.
I like the feel of this.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at this, it almost makes me, it's like a bittersweet type of feeling. You know what I mean? It's like you know this was 1993, so New York was how it was back then. And it's like, man, look, man, like just everything looks so peaceful. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oop.
That's so mean.
Hmm. Oh, I like the chorus too.
I do too.
And you know something else?
That gave me goosebumps.
Yeah. You know something else that
I
kind of.
The Twin Towers, babe.
I was going to say that when I paused it right
there.
Oh
my gosh. I knew it.
Yeah, I was going to say that like after we kind of got towards the end when I paused it right here because I noticed it. But I like the Bee Gees when they start harmonizing, when they all kind of like singing together.
Yeah.
It's like that whole tone, I guess like you were saying, like they all kind of sound together.
Yeah.
No, I mean, you're saying they all sound alike.
Yeah.
But, you know, I definitely hear it. I definitely hear it when they start all singing together.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, and they just got their own, like, unique sound.
I was going to say, I like the mixing sound that they have. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, they sound very much, you know, like, in sync with each other. But they just in terms of, like, the differentiality in terms, like, of them individually.
Yeah.
I like the feel, though.
I do, too.
Yeah.
And shout out to them, the Twin Towers in the back, too.
Man. Forever, okay?
It looked like it was cold out there, though.
It looked like it was so much. Oh gosh, that, like freezing cold.
And that is New York in the Christmas time.
Yeah.
In December, so you know
that's how they go.
Freezing cold.
That's how they go. Okay.
But I like this one. I like the whole live performance, especially again me having an opportunity to hear the Bee Gees and see the Bee Gees and do it live as well. Again with the Bee Gees, they're classy. Like when I hear the Bee Gees. It's like you know their tone or their voice.
Yeah, it's almost like they have a classic sound. Like I just feel like it's an irreplaceable like tone. Like you can't,
exactly.
Especially the leader of the group. His voice specifically stands out to me for some reason. I mean, I guess for the obvious, but
as soon as a Bee Gees song comes on, or you hear a Bee Gees like the hook of a song with the Bee Gees, like you know it's them.
This makes me think like of the classic, like you know, listening the sound of it. The sound, not the song itself, but the sound of it makes me think of like, you know, like the classic love romantic type movies that we used to watch like back in the day. That sound is like
the sound. This is like we like the soundtrack to it.
Yeah.
Or to like a heartbreak a little bit too in the song as well. You know?
Or that.
Yeah.
Or that.
From whom the bell tolls, babe.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. I love this. I love the aesthetics of this video. It couldn't be like more realistic.
Yeah.
You know, having the backdrop of like freaking New York City in the background, like it festers up like so many thoughts and emotions and feelings and
exactly,
you know what I mean, happy fuzzy feelings.
I went to New York a couple of times around Christmas time. It wasn't 93, maybe what 94, 95,
yeah.
But yeah, New York was a very very beautiful time in those mid 90s and still is.
Yeah.
Man,
I'm just saying that because I'm just like, you know, there was a time where. Now it's like you can't even mention New York without mentioning New York. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Everything that has
transpired. And a lot of things have changed too as far as like how you can kind of move around the city too.
Absolutely. Yeah. A lot has changed. I'm just saying, you know, in terms of like the memories, you know, a lot of people have probably made a lot of memories when New York was what it was.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? But, you know, hey, We are resilient. We are a resilient country. I believe in that. So.
Absolutely. But like my last question with the Bee Gees, like is the Bee Gees, would they be considered like alternative rock? Because I get like that laid back feel. It's definitely like rocking to it, but it's
That's a good question.
Laid back alternative too. It's like a mesh between those two.
Yeah.
I just want to know.
And that's a good question. Just because there's so many like categories of rock. Mm-hmm. I think we've started to learn that now. Yeah. So it's almost like, yeah, I don't even know, babe. That's a good question.
Yeah.
I feel like it would be though. Like to me, because it is more of the laid back, calmer. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Yeah. So.
Shout out to the Bee Gees though. This was a good song.
I enjoyed that. So if y'all enjoyed this video, be sure you give us a big thumbs up, a like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any videos from Asia and BJ. And if ain't nobody told you, I love you. And we're gonna see y'all in the next video, y'all. Bye.
Let's go.